said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Winners' Bracket Quarterfinals. Na'Vi going up against Quantic, game number two now for this matchup. Who will get to go through will be Quantic, who at this point are undefeated in the defense. Na'Vi, they have been defeated once. Will they be defeated again? We're going to find out. They've already lost one match in this one. Let's jump ourselves inside the draft. The game has already begun. There will be a very, very quick remake at the conclusion of this game due to the fact that Na'Vi don't have their proper profile up. Also for the fact that Dota TV has not been activated. So for those guys out there who are wondering where is Dota TV and why am I seeing this on the live stream before I'm seeing on Dota TV, there's your reason why the game will be remade. So do not fear. We are here to help you watch Dota in multiple ways. That's what it's all about, guys. So yeah, let's check it out with our draft so far. Puppy being the one to draft up for Na'Vi. So Lycan as well as Darkseer. Morphling going to add into the ban pool as well. So removing of one of Kurok's favorite heroes. Quantic banning out the Broodmother, the Prophet, as well as the SD. So SD able to couple up with almost anything on the field. Prophet also a great hero whenever Na'Vi want to do that. Both Prophet as well as Broodmother able to split push very, very easily. And Na'Vi do kind of like that. They like just throwing that one hero on the side lanes, like Light of Heaven. Just do your thing, man. Just do your thing. In the last game, it was Havorce doing it with a Tinker, which didn't 100% work into the later game. And that's the reason why Quantic were able to get through and take out that first game. When Na'Vi, we look at them this time around, we go Rubick and we go SK. So, look to see Enigma picked up here by Quantic, unless they want to give that to Puppy in this third selection. And even if they do, then Denny will just steal it when he takes that Rubick to the solo mid. Which is a role he also does play. He likes just swiping that Rubick over towards the solo mid. It's just like, hey, sup, I get farm. And hey, maybe I'll be proved wrong in this game. Maybe I'll be proved wrong in this game. So far, in every single game I've seen it, and Slash just like, maybe I am a curse to all Rubick players who are support players. It doesn't work as support. But it could this time around. It could this time around. Kabat tried to prove me wrong before. We'll see if I'll get proved wrong here by Na'Vi. Probably not. We'll probably look to see Puppy take up that Enigma as a support. If they want to go down that lines as well, depends on how much aggression they want to find. Does NS take up that role as the SK and does he become the support? Brewmaster and TA here by Painted Gold. Radiant team pick. Aggressive middle lane. Such a hard hero to play up against. Templar Assassin. I'm wondering how Na'Vi really want to go with this one. I'd look to see Venomancer picked up as a third one. The main reason for Venomancer, and Painted Gold said it himself when he was joining me for the broadcast the other night, when you have that Venomancer ulti go off or even just a Gale, that tick over gets rid of the refraction. Because every tick is a refraction charge. So because of it, you're like, well, damn it, I've lost all my refraction, I don't get to do my damage. So Na'Vi, they won't look for these heroes, which is the instant burst damage. They've got to look for that continuous ticking or right-click at a fast rate to bring him down. That's what they'll try and do. And Enigma, there's that third pickup. You gotta remember, every conversion which hits ticks over the refraction. So look at it that way. They look at the fact they've got this great ulti combos. I've also got to look at the fact too that Rubick is able to steal the Brewmaster ultimate. He can steal the Shrek's Edict. He can even steal TA's traps if he wants to, or meld. Use it that way. Can't steal, of course, the passives, but that's okay. And we go into our next stage of the banning. So Quantic, they've got two heroes to ban out. And they go look... They can't really look at mid-solos. And this is a problem when you go with a draft with these first three pickups from Na'Vi. You got to say, side lane is the only thing I can ban right now. There goes the Naga ban. That's just a safety ban. This is a full safety ban so they don't lose full control over the team fights. Which is what Brewmaster is meant to be the counter for. But you start looking at this way and go, well, I don't know what lanes they're going to run. It's a possible support Rubick. We might know that Denny runs him as a solo mid, but that doesn't mean that, like, Rubick is not going to go into a different role. That Enigma won't be played, well, and Puppy will be playing Enigma, believe me. But how's the other roles start like, lining in now? How do you run your lanes? Do we try and ban out the mid solos, or we just say let's ban out Havorce hero, which I think is what Painted Gold is thinking right now. It's the only thing you can really ban out, and it's the big heroes for Havorce. Well, you already know Quantic's Heroes because it's exactly what they would love to play. Paint it gold, takes that Brewmaster for a solo mid almost every single time. And they'll support him up with a Crystal Maiden or something like that, just to give him that little bit of extra oomph in the lane. Maybe in a Venomancer if they want to try and go a little bit more aggressive on Rubick. And that's a possibility. This is the reason why it's taking so long. It's like Puppy, in fact, DC's out from the game. I'm not hearing anything else. Yeah, reconnects back into the game. So lost a little bit of extra time looking at this fourth ban. And will he just ban out the Crystal Maiden or not? Also, I don't know why Puppy's having so much internet connection troubles. Yeah, he might be back in Estonia. Because I know Na'Vi are trying to boot camp themselves up soon, and there's even a house to help them do so. Because it's only 1 month before they make the trek to Seattle. And then all hell's going to break loose. And we all meet on the same ping. Ooh. 10 seconds. I'm really looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to the international. If you're going to be in America, come up and say hello. Come up and say hello. I gave that invite out for DreamHack, and a lot of people ended up doing it as well. So if you are going to be at the international, come up and say hello. I will be there broadcasting. The guy I was broadcasting the last game with, not the last game with Na'Vi versus Quantic, but the MTW versus CLG game, if you didn't see it, I highly suggest you check out at least game one of the VODs, which are already available over on joindota.com. You can check them all out already. I believe some of them are also starting to appear up on YouTube. YouTube always takes longer to process than O3D TV. But yeah, Slash will be the one broadcasting with me on the main stage. I believe also there are plans to have Cinderin join me if his team gets eliminated. It all depends on if his team gets eliminated. He'll probably join me a little bit later on, but we might jump between the two. It'll depend on the teams. Because the Chinese, there is very few people who have the insight that Slash does. So now we're rolled in for our last two bans. Queen of Pain was banned out by Na'Vi. So maybe they're still thinking about the offlanes as well. Because that's one thing Quantic don't really have unless they want to run an aggressive tri-lane. And the Shadow Demon's already banned out, and that was normally the setup you'd use with Lefrak and Brewmaster. So more than likely, it's not going to be an aggressive tri-lane by Quantic. They want to go a little bit more safer. And they might just ban out the Beastmaster as our final ban from Na'Vi. Thinking about that other side lane, there goes the Windrunner and BS insta-ban. They do not want Puppy being interrupted during the Black Hole. By that time for Brewmaster to get the ult off, hell freaking no. But Quantic, are they going to see if they can take up a jungle hero as well? Chen's still available for them if they want it. Wouldn't be a bad selection as well. That's good pushing power to combine up with Lefrak. First pick, however, does go the way of Quantic, so they can choose now. And there's not a lot of bonus time left for both these teams. So they must make their choices. 10 seconds remaining. And just grabbing up the Chen right now would be an easy selection. And they go and say, screw it, we're going to go Invoker. So Brax gets his side lane Invoker again, which does now force an interesting change up in the lanes. Because you got 3 heroes to need the farm. Brewmaster, you got the PA. Oh, sorry, TA. And then Invoker. All 3 heroes require farm, which means Lashrak's got to go support. This is an aggressive tri lane by Quantic. It's got to be. Mid lane solo. Invoker up towards that top lane. Brewmaster Lashrak plus 1 down towards the bottom lane. Dire team. And they get the Pugnum Ward. This works in 2 ways. One, to control the team fights, because there are a large amount of mana costs coming out from Quantic. But it's also, when you go into that meld, which most Templar Assassins don't use it this way, and you can hide inside the meld. But Pugnum Blast definitely will pull you back out of this again. So now one last pick up by Quantic. Are they going to go with the aggressive hero? Are we going to look at a Crystal Maiden or something like that? Enchantress. And we go Enchantress. They're going to grab their own jungler. Radiant team pick. I'm really interested to see how they're going to lane this. If this does become an Enchantress Lashrak and Brewmaster bottom lane. It's possible they let Painted Gold solo the Brewmaster mid and then just have Enchantress and Lashrak rotate. That's another big option as well. But you have to throw the Invoker or Refraction TA down there. And Na'Vi, they've got one more selection as well. And they've got to decide who they want to put the farm on. Havorst, it's difficult. Because now it starts screwing with the lanes. Because where do you throw the Pugna? Who goes up on that top lane? Earthshaker is their final one. There is no mid-game real carry in this. It's going to be Havorst on that SK again. It's got to be a Vorsen SK. We're going to have a very, very quick remake, guys. The players might select up their guys right now. Nope, there we go. Everyone's now DCing. So we will do the same and join the remake. So we're going to have the profiles back up again for all the players. Which I'm pretty sure Holy Master is going to very, very nicely remind Na'Vi about. Or I could do so. Because Na'Vi don't have their full five, so it doesn't automatically click on. They go do it manually, and there we go. Thanks, puppy. And then, so our last player to come in for Na'Vi, the support, NS, playing with them this evening. Poor Vasuda. He's been kicked out of the ob slots. We need our Russian stream. I'm pretty sure he does, Holly. I'm pretty sure he does. So they're asking right now if he's got his in-game audio activated. Nice. But yeah, so one last player coming from Na'Vi, Quantic. They are 2-0 off, like we always do for our reminders. If you want to keep up to date with anything that happens for the defense, the-defense.com is the website. Or joindota.com is our homepage. You can find all the live streams over there. You can see what's going on in everything that's Dota. Be it the joindota open, which finished up earlier tonight, so you can see that the Space Monkeys had some good fun winning that one out. That's the public competition that we run for everybody. So if you want to compete in one of those, I believe our next joindota open is planned for very, very shortly after the international, maybe even one beforehand. I do not know. All I know is it's in the works. And that game is now loading in too, guys, so don't fear too much. And yeah, everything else, as far as like even Gozu League, we've got BTS World Tour coverage. Gozu League has, in fact, even got two games live right now. But let's jump ourselves inside the game. It's where we want to go to. We'll go to our draft as well, which will happen in just a moment. We should be in all pick mode, so the draft won't happen, won't take too long. With NS, he was the last player to connect in for Na'Vi, and he's going to be our last player as well to load into the game. Everyone else is good to go. Hey, Dota TV is working. Fantastic. Awesome. Groovy. Hit that button. Make sure it works. That's what it's all about. So shout out to everyone who is tuning in from inside the game client. I know I was with you in the last game. I think there's 350 people watching from inside the client. So those guys bought their Defense 2 tickets. So they're able to watch any game, be it our current or later. Because these games, if you do want to watch any of the replays, you can check out the VODs from over on the joined database, or you can also basically jump yourself inside the game. Click on the game and download, watch away. Life is very, very simple when you do that. So here we go again. So all pick mode, you get to roll it off, and I want to see these lanes from Na'Vi, and I want to see how ES works. I'm going to laugh. If it's going to be Dendi on Earthshaker again, I am going to laugh my ass off. Yeah, you guys are already talking about it because we've got to remember what Dendi did as the Earthshaker. It was ridiculous what he did. We ended up having like a Daedalus, a BKB up on the Earthshaker, which doesn't only seem like much, but when you add the Totem Bodice damage with the Daedalus crit, you can almost one-hit a hero. And then you add the Echo Slam on top of that one. He's jumping after everyone with the Blink Daggers. It's on the lines of brutal. It's on the lines of brutal. All right, so now we should be in AP mode and jump ourselves inside the game. So what have we got? Let's look at Na'Vi last. I want to check out Quantic. So Kurok will be taking up that role as our wonderful lady in pink, the Templar Assassin, also known to the world as TA. We'll have Mikey. I call him Mikey up there on the Enchantress. Matrim will be taking up the Lathrak support. So that'll be the Trite lane heading up towards the top lane this time around. Painted Gold will be taking that Brewmaster to the solo mid, and that leaves Brax for the Quas Invoker. He's already realizing he's having a hard time on that bottom lane. So he's going to go Quas Invoker on the bot lane. And really, I did not see things working out too well for him. I got a funny feeling that Quantic are already predicting that Na'Vi are going to be running the aggressive tri lane on top, but that's not going to be the case here. So Na'Vi all grouping up. They're not really looking for smoke. They're looking for Quantic to either try and go around this way or come around this way. But nobody's here. This is a no-go zone. And now Puppy will be like, oh, okay, yeah, sweet. No one's here. It's going to be a bottom lane solo. And as is the Earthshaker, already going to put an aggressive ward up. Then we get Puppy as the Enigma, Avorst as that bottom lane Pugna, so he gets his farm down there. Light of Heaven will be the Sand King, so that's the top lane solo. And then Dendi in towards the mid lane is Rubik. So Na'Vi do their standard. They do what they always do. So this is what would be predicted. Light of Heaven just DCing for a moment. I'll wait for him to get back into the game. And how long this battle lasts up on the top lane, I'm not quite sure. Lestrade can pull SK out of the sandstorm, and SK's going to get nothing up here. Light of Heaven's going to know this. He'll move up towards that top lane and be like, well, I'm normally pretty okay with doing a side lane, but Quantic aren't running the aggressive lane on the bottom lane, like what I believe Na'Vi would be expecting. It's a late game Enchantress is nothing compared to a late game Enigma. Loses the power. So in this scenario, oh, really, Light of Heaven? I thought he just reconnected back in again. Disconnected, reconnected, disconnected. Sweet. Guessing he's got himself a nice small little bug up his sleeve. But just how well Light of Heaven goes with this SK on the top lane, let's just watch this little box here very, very closely. Alright, so now he's back inside the game. So, Painted Gold always ready to play. Puppy as well. So very little time wasted. And Brax watching for that bottom rune. Invis room for NS would be very, very nice, and it's not. Invisibility. It's top lane, and it's Kurok who ends up taking it. Still hasn't leveled up anything just yet. Probably not 100% sure if he wants to get a refraction or what. And hello, Matrim, as well as Mikey. They might just be looking for one easy creep to start with, just get it from this camp here, and then move out. See if they can gank up that middle lane. Already Denny with a couple of conversions. They might have shared control on that one too. Puppy already looking for the denials. And taking last hits as well. Anything that's going to stop Painted Gold. Painted Gold loves running this mid lane and getting their bottle up early on. And ends up using that Thunderclap. Use it for last hitting. For him, it's a lot more effective. Now NS down here on the bottom lane. Starts with a pull. It's not doing a double pull, it's doing a normal pull. So they're getting some momentum behind this creep wave on the bottom lane. I don't know if this is 100% intentional. Maybe it is. Of course, be like, well, I can damage down the tower with my blast, so I don't really care where the creep wave is. Denial's trying to come up here by Quantic. And let's look at SK in the top lane. Managed to pick up half a level. That's more than what I thought he'd get. It's a lot more than what I thought he'd get. And then the harassment from Matron pushes him back. And this is where life becomes hell. NS. Oh, man. Not double pull. Does the smart thing. Keeps pushing up, trying to hold Brax out of the play. And Brax, see if he can take the creep wave aggro. He's going to take the aggro from the jungle, at least. But this gives a lot of space for Havorce to keep farming up. Getting free levels. Easy last hits in. So life's not too bad. And while this is going on, we've got Enigma. Who's here inside the jungle. The only downside for Brax right now is the fact he's got level 2. And if you're a Na'Vi fan, well, actually no, SK, he's got level 2. Sandstorm is up. He still can't do anything against Matrim because he's got that split earth at level 1. Which means if you want to jump inside the Sandstorm, this is going to be a very quick rotation from the Leshrac and you've got the kill. ES coming down. Going to try and harass Brax back a little bit. But really, Brax can harass VP, NS a lot more. Just keeps those Ryklis going with the Cold Snap. And NS takes a decent chunk of aggro. But because of this, though, Pugna still gets a good farm. 2 points up on Blast. Haste. Puppy makes the rotation across. Wanting to push Brax even further up the lane. How's our middle lane looking? Painted Gold. Currently sitting at 5-1 on his CS up against Denny. He's got 12-5. This middle lane is just is wipe for Quantic. But top lane's great for Quantic. Got Korok at 15-7. He's saying almost par here with Havorce. He's letting up a couple of blast gates. We're getting rid of these towers. Couple of conversions here from Puppy as well. And they keep Invoker falling back. New creep wave's going to arrive. It's still going to take him some time. But with the second level there on the blast from Puppy, they can bring down this tower. And fortification's already been used. Brax trying to call snap up on Puppy, but he can't really get close enough to keep that damage flying out. Trying to kill off a couple of conversions, but we've got a new creep wave coming in. And Puppy can create new conversions in 11 seconds. And they just keep with these blasts, keep the aggression going. But then again, top lane's the same. They've got Enchantress helping off, Centaur as well as Alpha Wolf, so this damage is already pretty damn high, and Light of Heaven's coming some extra splash damage from those side blades. He's just trying to nuke down the creep wave. And there goes the T1 tower. Pugna takes it, no chance for a denial. But the top tower is going to be taken by Quantic. And this is kind of where Nami's push ends. They're out of consumables. It cost Puppy a decent amount of those clarities to do what he did. He still has he does have 900 gold, so if he wants Sol Ring, he can buy one. Just means the courier's going to make the trek, and that courier's going to start flying sometime soon. But you look at the top lane, you got Lautrec with 2 points up on Edict. Plus still the Centaur and Alpha Wolf. This push can keep going on the top lane. And this is what Na'Vi's push can't do. And this is also the power of Lautrec. Light of Heaven, he's got to accept the fact this tier 2 tower is gone. Even if they bring in support to stop this, it's going to cost them too much. Oh, sniping the courier. A little of sloppy control there by Na'Vi means that Marky's able to just snipe that guy off, and that's a lot of extra gold now for Quantic. Na'Vi are in a horrendous position. Brax with that Quas, so easy to stand up against a Vorst. Good regen. And a Vorst missing just a couple of these blasts as well. Trying to catch him on the edge so he can get the creep wave as well as the hero. That's a slight over committal to get that. How's Puppy looking? He still hasn't got that Sol Ring yet. He must have bought the Flying Courier as well. Well, actually, no, he didn't, because the Courier went down the top lane. But yeah, no Flying Courier. He just spent his cash, but just a possible source of back at base. No, it's not in his stash. He hasn't dropped it on the ground. Radiance, so maybe he is just that far behind. Attack. But he had more money. He had 900 gold. I'm sure he did. Oh, well. 16 for 2, and now Dendi returns towards the mid lane. Regen room bottled up for him. And he'll look for painted gold. 3 points up in that thunderclap, and painted gold still hasn't hit level 6 yet. Dendi would love that primal split. It's going to be a difficult thing to grab, however. Main reason for that is, like, you pop the primal split, and then, well, you can't grab it. I don't know if you actually grab from the three illusions. Well, technically they are illusions, but from the three broodlings. That's a force looking level 6 now for him. Top lane push, Light of Heaven. He's up to level 5 now, so it's not too bad for him. Like, normally I'd say this is a horrendous lane on the top lane, because, oh my god, the goal is just so far behind. But Light of Heaven, he's able to stand pretty well here. Like, Kurok doesn't want to get too aggressive on this top lane. He knows the problems that could be facing him if he does. Because then the rotation can come out and we don't know where Puppy is. He's spending a lot of his time here in the jungle. Oh man, Brewmaster has popped that ult, he's looking for NS. Support coming down, and Dendi, he's got points and Thunderclap. NS, he is still getting stunned up, and Brax comes in. First blood spilled. We're about to see Havorst hit the deck. The clap coming out there by Rubick, and now Painted Gold goes in again, and now Dendi can pop off his own Brewmaster ultimate. So while he might have lost the Pug, it's a double kill now for the Invoker. He chases down Brax, Stun flies out there, hits on Painted Gold. He really wants his Brewmaster. Matrim's going to come in to help off. That stun does no effect, man. It won't really help him off, and Brewmaster, he's going to get out of here. He's overcommitted. There's a lot of Quantic coming in here, and now Denny's a long way from home. It's going to be 3 kills going the way of Quantic. Not just one, but 3 kills all going the way of Invoker. And now Puppy has been brought down by Kurok, who's rotated from the top lane. He's teaming up with Brax. Even the Saturns are turning on Puppy. They know what he's done to many, many a neutral camp over time. Havorz comes in to help off. Decrepifies, so Kurok can't attack him. The shield's already gone now by Kurok, but they already got the kill on Puppy. Trap goes as well. Fissure flies out by NS. And Havorz will get the kill here on the Invoker. Killing up the Spree, but Kurok, a double kill for him now. Both Puppy as well as Pugner on the sidelines. And Painted Gold now rotates bottom lane to get more farm down here. But Quantic off to a fantastic start. The experience wasn't really going their way before because all they were really getting was map control. But now they have 2k. And Dendi will swipe the Edict. They're so far behind in gold. 4k already. 2k as far as experience goes. And a Quantic, they're already going to try for Roshan. I suppose they got the heal from Enchantress and that Wilkin that can tank up. And Kurok's Refraction helps him out too. And there we go, Refraction's now worn off, and in fact they're going to use the Wilkins Tornado. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Gonna laugh if that Roshan takes aggro onto the Wilkin and stops the channel. Roshan being brought down, this is another big problem for Na'Vi. More and more gold. Not to mention the Aegis Immortal on Kurok. And that's a kill they really, really want to claim, but they cannot do so. Force, nice stun. Not going to block him in place. Decrepify and Malifus also trying to combine them together. Roshan down 400, 300, 200, 100. And Tornado slowing them down. Temple Assassin picks up the Aegis the Immortal now. And Na'Vi know what was all being done beforehand. The Vorsaunt's one more blast to kill off this tower. It won't be enough, however. Feybolt, nice harassment. And that creep wave to start attacking on the tower, and then one last blast from Pugna. And that won't level up the towers, but definitely help. More painted gold. Long way for him to jump in. Getting pulled in, from Dendi. And the TA trap just trying to make Na'Vi think twice about engaging again. They want this tower down in mid, but it's not within deny range. It's 23 points above it. And Avorz keeps going with those arcane boots, giving Dendi more mana to spam out. He's still holding onto that regen rune inside his bottle. So they can keep on pushing through. And there, Edict damage was taken by Dendi before and used to bring down the towers. And they want to rotate top and use the most of this. He won't have that for too long. In fact, he's probably going to get like maybe 20, 25 seconds left on that. And he's going to catch out Brax. Or Brax, I should catch out Dendi. The support's already rotating in. Painted gold. He does have that ultimate up his sleeve. And what is Dendi doing? Aggressive ward behind. They want to see who's coming. They'll see Brax. And then they'll see Painted gold. So see him already. Dendi, cold snap. Very, very hard to cast anything. But sending the Brax back a little bit further. Fitch goes out and Painted gold. Still hasn't popped off the ultimate just yet. Matron was thinking about coming from the side. Dendi, you are a long way from home, man. He's popping up the Edict damage. Does a lot of damage to the Painted gold. And the Edict damage keeps going through. But unfortunately for Dendi, he brought in the creep wave as well. So the aggro started to soak up. Puppy getting caught out by a TA trap. And now Brewmaster pops off the ultimate. At the same time, the Fisher starts flying off. Sun's already going off on Kurok. But Enigma's already taken a fall. Line of Heaven trying to juke around the trees here. He had an epicenter, which he desperately wanted to use. But Kurok now with a Blink Dagger, which he doesn't have to desperately use. He does use it very, very effectively. Picking off the Sand King. And now Painted Gold looking at NS. Lets off the Thunderclap. Nice fissure. And Painted Gold a little bit too far up. He's caught out there. Tornado sends him up. One imp. There we go. Flies out. Enchantress gets a kill on NS. And nice EMP as well. Dendi out of mana. He might suck the Edict. And he'll pop it off himself. But Enchantress now with a double kill. Trying to give the Invoker a little bit of extra life. The Edict damage actually. Was there an urn charge there? Yeah, it was. And just stopped the heal. And Invoker's going to walk all the way back to base. Painted Gold has no desire to. But Quantic now, 11 for 1 up against Na'Vi. Keeping their very, very big run going.
Thanks.
And then, yep, there's the line's already been drawn. And that's actually from the ES. That's from NS. He's just basically saying, hey guys, watch out for this lane. Kurok, Malifa stunned up, Puppy. He's still not level 6 yet. There's no black hole. That's why Na'Vi really couldn't take that fight in the top lane either. But they want to push down the towers. Map control was more important to them. Now Kurok. Oh my lord! Oi, yoi! 4 points up on Meld. With the phase boost, Blink Dagger gets in the perfect position. T1 tower will be brought down by Na'Vi, but Puppy, he is going to feel so cut about that. He was doing what he could, though. All he could really do was try and hold the tower. Bottom lane TP, Dendi comes in. And already pulling back the Enchantress, and Vorst here as well with a blast and the Fate Bolt damage. But Mikey's heal keeps him up. And he's still got 2 urn charges. All these kills that Quantic got, they all went on to Mikey's urn. He spammed off a lot of them too, so Quantic didn't have to fall back. So he could try and keep the pressure on. And they're going to add some pressure right now. Already the trap being set, and they're looking for Dendi. Yay! Yay! That is not Orpa! That is not Orpa! And now Avorz will be focused down. Meld comes off cooldown. He does the whole combo again.
Is how you lasted so long.
That Meld is just brutal. Bonus damage of 200. And the armor reduction of 8. For people like Rubik as well as Pugna, there's just nothing there. And the biggest problem right now is the fact that Na'Vi have nothing that can stand up against this. They were so reliant with this draft on winning in the early game. That's going to mean the Quantic should late game be able to take this. Unless there is something absolutely magical pulled out by Na'Vi. And we're talking like one brutal last combo. And Brewmaster now, the Blink Dagger. Everything is working for Quantic. They're getting every item they want. Getting every kill they want. 7-0 now up on Kurok. 4-1 on the Invoker, 3-0 on the Enchantress. 1-4 is the highest for Na'Vi. The only person to get a kill so far is Havorst. And he's got 4 deaths to his name. 4 deaths for Denny, 3 deaths for Enigma. Na'Vi just have nothing on any of these heroes, and the trap scattered our puppy. It's watching him do these camps. And look for Kurok. He already wants to blink. Another trap. Blink up. Right click. Meld. Doesn't really have it right now. And there. Yep, more than enough. More than enough. In fact, he's going to give that one to Invoker. Kurok being the giving carry that he is. Now 1-15. Thank you. And Na'Vi really struggling. And they're only a very short amount of time away from dropping down that lower bracket. I know I'm probably going to get spammed up in a moment for who they could go up against, but at this point, their options, EG, SGC, and Pot and Bottom. They are the three teams that have advanced in the lower bracket. Ubalus and we as Asians play tomorrow. And who will join them in the bottom bracket? Either Mouse or Moscow 5. One of these teams will have to make the descent. And they play tomorrow night at 21 CEST. So the two games for the defense coming up for you tomorrow night. And here we go again. Havorst, gotta be careful. Ward behind the lines. Burrow strike up. Really nicely done. Three caught out. Line of heaven! Oh my lord! And Denny to couple onto it. Havorst will take a fall. Buyback's into the game by the Invoker. Puppy will probably take a fall. He's got the black hole up his sleeve, but there's an Earth Panda sitting right in front of him. Kurok running in on Denny, but Denny says no go! The secret. And Kurok will go down, but Denny is not finished just yet. He's stolen Refraction, that's why against Andrew that engagement, and Kurok instantly blinks away. They will take up this mid lane. So the buyback by the Invoker, the Aegis Immortal popped. They'll lose their tier 2 tower as well as 4 heroes. But it will stop there. Brewmaster Ottoman was forced. Invoker almost died again just then. And 1v1, yeah, Denny's calling it. Dendi is calling it. Now he's got the Refraction. He believes he can take it. And the really funny thing is, he can. He can actually take this. Because the Feybolt will remove off the damage. Kurok can't attack him because the Refraction will be there. And Dendi has good output of damage. Now blink in by Puppy. He's going to spot Matrim. Matrim is in the worst possible position. Yep. There's a pause there. It's the only way he was there. And Puppy is just like... thank you. Thank you very much. 19-3. I think it's about to become 19-4. And Matchup now reconnects. And we'll realize the horrible, horrible truth. I was left behind. Kurok's not ready yet. What's he going to do? We got a Brewmaster down the side. Oh, nope. Matchup's out again. We got Mikey and Painted Gold here, and all Paint wants is the regen rune. I think he realizes that killer's gone. That's the problem when you have disconnects. Life is hell, man. Life is hell. But that was a big fight for Na'Vi. That was a really big fight. Without the black hole. The black hole did nothing in that one. Puppy wanted to pop it off just because he thought he could. I think he hoped that Brueling didn't have that stun up his sleeve. I've also just found out, thank you very much to Ham Sandwich, who's passing me out these details. The loser of this game plays the winner of Ubalist and We Has Asians. So either Na'Vi or Quantic will find out who their opponent is at the end of the game tomorrow night. Also looking as well, looks like we'll only have time to cast one of the games tomorrow night. Ubalist and We Has Asians happens almost at the same time as Mouseports versus Moscow 5. So it's basically only one broadcast coming out for you tomorrow night. But once that's over... we have our semi-finals, and then our 4 matches for the round 1.5, which is basically the quarter-finals of the lower bracket. It's the preliminary matches for the lower bracket right now, if we can look at it that way. But we're definitely progressing ourselves through, and of course all of this is going to end over the next two, three weeks. Puppy. Yeah, Matrim. Sorry, ma'am. Teddy comes in. Oh Matrim, no one can save you. Nobody can save you from that. Oh, now Puppy has himself a blink dagger. Did use the black hole during that last engagement though, so it's on cooldown for another 2 minutes. But the rate Quantic are going, it's taking them a lot longer than that. And Kurok, the damage dealing item. Now he'll be happy to go one-on-one with Dendi. With that armor hit, will still go. Nice increase in damage. Takes two of those Desolators. Two Tessellators. Two Mithril Hammers plus the recipe for Deso. So a nice increase in damage. Plus that negative armor with every hit. Not really meant for anybody, but because everyone's got so little armor, they become so easily killable with just a couple of right clicks. And by the time he's got a couple of those right clicks in, you have nothing. You've got no armor, and you have done no damage to him because Refraction just shields it all. Now we've got Voice Zone very, very quickly picked up. Who is that for? Is that going to be for... Well, I assume it to be Dendi. Yeah, he's going Yule Scepter. Yule Scepter for Dendi. So this is his Rubik build. He doesn't have enough to finish it just yet. He still needs the 300 gold to buy the recipe. But this is double disable. This is the way Dendi likes to play the Rubik. Oh!
You'll never know the mysteries.
So, ladies and gentlemen, PA. PA? Ladies and gentlemen. Except it's not, it's TA. LOL! And now she's gonna go BKB. So stay ability, more damage as well. It is getting ridiculous, the amount of damage that can pump out from her. But this is the start. There's always the start you look for on a mid-game power hero like this. PA and TA are put in exactly the same boat. At this point of the game, their damage, no matter what item you have, you cannot deal with it. That's just what happens when both these heroes get a good start. That's why I always keep them putting PA and TA together and putting their initials around the wrong way. Some big items now coming up from Na'Vi. Black Hole's off cooldown, and we've got Blink Dagger up on SK. So as far as team fights go, Na'Vi's got the whole kit and caboodle. Brewmaster, however, he is that other fun little guy who's about to pick himself up. No, nope. You can see Mortal goes to Kurok again. With a double damage rune as well. It's really nice knowing you, Roshan. Dendi having that Yule Scepter. It's going to make a big, big difference. Pull TA out of the fight. Doesn't matter if he's got Refraction. Or even Brewmaster. Pull him out of the fight. He'll hit the deck and then instantly pop ulti. But you might also be able to bait out the ulti a little bit earlier than what Painted Gold wants to do. And that's always a big question that comes out. Like, Painted Gold could be losing a lot of life. It's like, when do I hit that R button? When do I want to pop my ultimate? Because if he waits too long, he'll go down. Then the black hole can do the rest. Whoop! Hello, top lane. There goes Mikey. And Puppy and Avorst. Spamming him up. Nothing like the troll chat. Now we do get a little bit vocal when it comes to in-game. Wait for a land event. And they were banging on the glass I think it was actually Scythe. Who, when they went to the international, were known as Scythe, and now they're known as Zenith. But just a slightly different roster. They were banging on the glass of those guys. They were really trying to get up in their face. Say, you know what? We're here to win. What are you here for? Light of Heaven looking towards his bottom lane. And it's a very, very smart time for Brax to retreat out of this. They already know that Blink Dagger's up in Light of Heaven. And they go look for an opening. Kurok is farming up inside Ancients, and what's he get? Now, yeah, full BKB done for him. Na'Vi still have the option of getting that black hole out in him. But with no BKB up on Puppy himself, he's still going to be very, very cautious. There's, well, technically three heroes that could stop it. Brewmaster with the Earth Panda, or Earth Ruling. Lothrak with his stun, which is a little bit more riskier because it's going to come in a lot closer. And then you're going to have Invoker with his Cold Snap, but that also requires him getting a right click out. So it's not 100% guaranteed they're going to stop Puppy's Blink. And it's not also guaranteed they can kill him off instantly either. They got 950 HP on Puppy because he got the double gauntlet. And he's probably looking to build up an urn. Well, then again, do we have an urn on anybody else? Smoke to run? Yeah, we're going to look for a gank, and we've got triple Blink Dagger now. Triple Blink Dagger up on Na'Vi. ES has got one, Light of Heaven's got one, Puppy's got one. And the rotation line being drawn out by Puppy already is go through the jungle and then up. And then the counter line by Denny is like, why don't we just take the tier 2 tower on bot? And the reason why is because Kurok is demolishing your creep wave in mid. They must rotate. They must rotate.
Raven's middle tower is under attack.
There's no TP up on Puppy. There's a TP up on... Well, how many TPs have we got? 1, 2, 3. Light of Heaven and Puppy have nothing. They need a kill. And hello again, Enchantress. Blink down by Puppy. Starts off with a stun. He's already call snapped up. And, Kurok pulls off the BKB very early on. Now Brewmaster jumps in. The Black Hole will pop, but Brewmaster already got his ulti off. So Black Hole's instantly cancelled again. Enigma is just disintegrated. Rubick will go down as well. Kurok getting too many kills. And Havorst, he was looking to TP out, and Kurok jumps himself up. And I am sorry, Havorst, but this is where your road ends. Kurok with a triple kill. And this should knock Na'Vi into the lower bracket to go up against the winner of Uberlust or We Has Asians. The amount of damage already coming off, the fortification will slow them down. And Nima back up again, but there's no Black Hole. Light of Heaven might want something else. But not gonna happen. Light of Heaven, Burrow Strike, goes through 3. Fisher to follow up. Would have been a great time for a Black Hole, but Quantic Noah's not up, and that's the reason why they do what they do. And TA just stands his ground, getting those kills. What did Denny manage to steal right now? He ended up stealing Trap. But Kurok, he's stealing all the life points of Na'Vi. Comes back down again, drops a Trap of his own, wants a right click. He's currently inside the meld, but all he wants is that extra damage when he comes back out of it. He's visible next to the fortress as well as the tier 4 towers. Continuously trapped up here by Dandy, and then the Pugnant Blast pops off as well. A lot of damage to Brax as well as to PA. TA. Just doing that. But the mid ranks is gone. And Quantic can keep going right now. But they decide to fall back. And Avor's looking for a kill. He wants to go solo. He's like, I know someone is here. And then again, they know he is there. Walks directly into it. Gets the one blast off and Kurok down. It's a pretty low life there, 82 life points is not a lot. But they cannot kill him. He's got 3,500 gold up his sleeve as well. I think Na'Vi just want one last amazing combo. Echo Slam, Epicenter, Puppy Black Hole. But Puppy's got to get this Black Hole away from the Brewmaster. But Painted Gold is such an experienced Brewmaster. Such an experienced Brewmaster. That there's just very little you can do against him. Now he's got the Aghanim set drop as well, so he does not give two hoots. And they just found Matrim. Hey, Matrim! Hey, Matrim! Stun. Burrow Strike. Malifus. Fissure. Dead. The Law Stun's already been used. And Puppy calls a GG. He's had enough of this one. They couldn't find a big opening. So Puppy has had enough of all of this. And Quantic, I think, want to finish it properly. But Quantic, they remain undefeated. Not a single game lost, even in this best of three up against Na'Vi. They don't lose a single game. They stay on top. And hello, Dendi. Now is his turn. Oh! Okay! Life! Kurok just sucks it out. Epicenter, but blink away by Kurok as well. Might have ever wants to chase him, but he's already used everything he's got. Fissure to fly, and Kurok starts off with the traps. He's thinking about Light of Heaven, but all he's got to do is just right-click through this wave, and it just demolishes. And Refraction back up again. Puppy now blinks in. He's got no mana. No mana. No life. TA just sucks it. And there's the go-on Line of Heaven. Nice sandstorm. Avoids the damage. But already getting brutalized. And TA with that last right click in. Does take it. And meanwhile on the bottom lane, Enchantress plus Brax pushing up against Avorst. He'll be able to take care of this creep wave, but he can't take care of the heroes. Cole snapped up. In fact, he will go down. Imps from Enchantress, as well as the creep wave attacking him, and the Cold Snap just kept on chaining off. And now Cold Snap up for Dendi. Gonna pull Mikey back up towards the high ground. But not using the Cold Snap just yet. Now Yule's getting the Invoker up into the air, and support is coming in by the Earthshaker. Fissure, Echo Slam, nice blink. Fissure to follow up. And would you believe the positioning of that from NS does hold the Enchantress in play. But then again, Enchantress has more damage than what they can pump out right now. Puppy will come through. He gets trapped up by TA, and you know what's coming in. Nice black hole. He knew Kurok was going to blink himself in for that one. But then again, Kurok won't really care. The trap to slow down NS. One click on Puppy, then maybe it's not going to be enough. Kurok, nah, what am I talking about? Refraction came up. Refraction instantly lost as well by the entire creep wave attacking him. Now he looks for Light of Heaven. That meld hit. Dropping the armor. And again with a Deso, and Kurok will take a fall. But the Aegis Immortal, how far away was that? 2.5 minutes. And Kurok's back up again. BKB, Vorse decrepifies himself and tries to TP out, but not enough time. Enchantress even coming into help for that one. And they just chase down. How many kills has he managed to achieve now? 19 for nil on Kurok. And Meld is now up for Tendi. Sends him up, pulls him down, jumps invis, and you can't deal the damage on your right click. Yeah, Refraction tanks it. The bonus 200 damage does nothing, but Yule Scepter again. Puppy comes up, couple Malphite stuns. He's still in range here of the fortress. So the stun will keep going, and again now with a meld from Dendi. Giving the negative armor, they might even be able to bring down Kurok. A 19 kill. This is going to be worth a crap ton of money for whoever gets it, but Brewmaster pops up the ultimate, and Kurok turns around to stand a fight. Dendi, he wants him to the bitter end, and he takes it. 705 gold. Finally ending the 20 killing spree there of Kurok. And he just sits on the sidelines, feeling very, very chuffed with himself, while Brax hangs in the tree line. The Broodlings cornered him in. And now they'll go for Dendi. The Stomps and Imps. He'll see himself up into the air, and Dendi, really? 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 He gets out safely. In fact, I don't think he's finished just yet. Yep, okay, he's finished. And that is the full Raxing. So Mega Creeps, not yet. Bottom lane, still be brought down. Yeah, well done, Havorst. That comeback, it was close. It was getting there. But 9 of 43. And we see the power of the Templar Assassin. Now with a Daedalus up his sleeve as well. So Kurok can end in style. And how many clicks will it take to bring down that bottom lane? Or who's he looking for? He's looking for Light of Heaven. Okay. Decent amount of crit. I'll give him that one. They cannot see Light of Heaven. They want him out of here. ES is also sitting by. And now Puppy, Sun's up and painted gold. He is going to be a three-hit wonder. And him flying out in NS. TA again with that kill. He just cannot stop him. And Kurok even going to come down for Dendi. 1v1. 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 Oh, meld, snap. And then he comes back out again. He bought dust. Kurok bought dust from the shop so he could reveal off Dendi. Or was that Dendi's? Or was it both? No, it was Kurok's. Kurok bought the dust so he could do that. And then jumps in and kills him. 23 for 1. He was waiting for the crit, and they wait for the GG, and Quantic will advance. Quantic will now advance through the next round, where they'll go up against Complexi in an All-American Canadian semi-final for the defense. When we look over towards the upper bracket, and MTW and CLG, we know CLG got through. Who will go up against them? You'll find out tomorrow at 21 CEST. It'll be Mousesports versus Moscow 5, a game which you will not want to miss because we've almost missed it 3 times in a row already, but we'll not miss it again. Thanks for tuning in today, guys. Thanks also for those guys who have been tuning in for the morning where we did the Guild Wars stream, as well as the Star Wars, as well as a couple of other things. Might be streaming that out again tomorrow, but yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys. This was your Saturday Dota, coming out from Join Dota. It's all about the Dota. We'll catch you guys tomorrow.
I said good day, sir!
Let's go, dance floor bro. I know, you know, I go psycho when my new joint hit. just can't sit. Gotta get jiggy with it. That's it. Now, honey, honey, come ride. DKNY, all up in my eyes. You got a Prada bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friend, let's spin. Everybody looking at me, glancing a kid. Wishing they was dancing a jig here with this handsome kid. Sick a cigar, right?